Previously on The Bill.
Yeah, Nixon, I've heard a lot about you.
All good, I hope. You're representing Tom Norris in the Paul Merrick case.
Yeah, it should be an interesting trial.
Just a pretty face, aren't you?
No.
There's nothing for me to worry about, is there?
Attempted rape of another woman. The 23-year-old Australian had been strangled. Tom Norris, from Canley, was arrested following the discovery of Vicky Miller's body in the boot of a car.
I never lost my temper! She said she wanted to make it work with her man!
Did you murder Vicky?
I'm not giving you the satisfaction. No comment.
Interview terminated, 8:59 p.m.
You bitch.
Going over the evidence against Tom Norris.
He startled me. I didn't expect anyone else in so early.
Can I do anything?
You can tell me we're going to win.
We're going to win. Who's up first in the witness box?
As far as I know, Nate, as the arresting officer, then forensics, then Fallon Thomas, Norris's flatmate Dan, followed by Paula, and then our similar fact witness, Sophia Duya. Has your wife said anything this morning?
No, she keeps it professional at this stage.
You've been on opposite sides before?
Not on a murder or attempted rape.
Must have made for an awkward breakfast.
I left before she got up.
Very wise.
Oh, Gov, do you want me to take Paula Merrick to court?
No, I've got Beth and Mel doing that. I'm more concerned about Fallon Thomas. She was supposed to come in for a chat yesterday and she didn't show up.
I'll get Uniform to find her.
Thank you. I mean, I know she's a car thief, but her evidence links Norris to the murder, and without that, it could be absolutely anybody. And I'm hoping by giving Paula the red carpet treatment, it might help her appreciate exactly how important she is today. Thanks.
Paula!
Well, it's still early. She might not be up yet.
Look, I can see that the telly's on. I don't like this.
Bubba, what do you want to do?
Fourth entry.
It's better than the top, isn't it?
They see with that, or we explain to the DIY we left her key witness at home. Paula? Paula? Are you here? Paula? Paula?
Mel?
She's here. Give us a hand.
There's an empty vodka bottle in the other room.
Call an ambulance.
See, Oscar from 258. Ambulance required at 2.
This similar fact witness thing, I don't get it.
Similar fact evidence means that your statement about Norris contains similar details to the other witnesses. It basically shows the court that he has choked other women. Now, the prosecution's case against Tom Norris is one of escalation, so that's cross sex with you, the attempted rape of Paula Merrick, followed by the murder of Vicky Miller.
Okay.
Now, your evidence relies on the fact that he put his hand over your mouth and he strangled you for pleasure. Have a seat, please, Sophie. There you go. Now, what you will have to do is show the judge and jury exactly how he did it.
The strangling was from behind, and with my mouth it was like this. Is that like the others?
I can't discuss the details, but the whole prosecution depends on his actions being identical in each case. So, draw your own conclusions.
Sean, you got a minute?
Excuse me.
Paula Merrick just hospitalised herself with a bottle of vodka.
How bad is she?
She's comatose. I think you should get down there. Banksy, your wife's in the front office. Now, this is nothing personal, but I want you to get rid of her. I don't want Norris's defence counsel hearing anything they shouldn't.
Oh. What are you doing here?
You're left without wishing me good luck. Listen, I know you're not giving evidence, but if you're coming to court, I thought maybe we could have lunch.
You could have called.
Why? What's wrong?
I don't understand why you came all this way to ask about lunch.
Do I need a reason? Seems like a nice idea. After missing you at breakfast. Something's wrong, isn't it? I know that look. Something happened on the Norris case.
Like I'm going to tell you.
Aren't you ready?
How ready do we have to be? The man's MO is as good as a confession.
Except it's the wrong man. And the lunch offer still stands.
I'll let you know.
Is that for good luck?
No.
Well,
thought she's due to be giving evidence in 2 hours. Have you spoken to her?
No, but as soon as the glucose trip's done, they say she can go. She's going to feel rough, Mum. Very rough.
OK, thank you. Hey, how are you feeling now?
Terrible.
Wasn't someone supposed to be with you?
You shouldn't need it.
Yeah, well, emotions have a habit of sneaking up on us sometimes.
I feel sick when I think about being in the same room as him.
Paula, you don't have to see him in court. There's a screen.
When I sleep, I have nightmares. When I'm awake, I have flashbacks. I can't cope with standing in front of strangers and going over it again. It's too much.
Paula, he tried to rape you. That's what's too much. And that's exactly why you need to stand up and tell it in court. Nurse.
She's never going to be ready in 2 hours, Mum.
She has to be. Along with Fallon Thomas, she's our most crucial witness. I'm going to get her discharged.
Fallon Thomas is a runner, apparently.
What kind of runner?
A man that runs from coppers.
In that case, I'll go round the back. She's over there! Leon! Come on.
Sierra Oscar from 437. It doesn't look like Fallon Thomas wants to come to court today. We're in pursuit on the Cockcroft estate.
I feel too ill.
Paula, we finally got him to court. Don't you want to hold him to account?
I know you do.
Yes, I do. To stop him. One woman's dead, and by the grace of God, you and Sophie are not. To convict him, we just have to show there's a pattern. We just need to put your two cases together.
It's taking me backwards. I was 6 weeks dry before this. I have to think about myself.
Please, can we just get you in the shower and then see how you feel?
Found this in your closet. Might be just right. They're gonna call me a drunken slut.
But you're not.
I can't get him out of here.
Come on. You've been beaten up enough. Don't do it to yourself. Dear Nixon.
Gov, uniform went to collect Fallon Thomas. She legged it. They can't find her.
Well, that's not good enough. You tell them to keep looking. And you make sure they understand how vital she is, okay?
Yes, Gov.
Mel.
Yes?
Fallon Thomas has done her honour. I don't know how you're going to do it, but you have to get Paula to court. If she's not there and Fallon doesn't show, the whole thing is going to unravel.
That's Paula Merrick.
Head she gets here, tail she doesn't.
But if she doesn't, what happens to comparing the attacks?
I'm counting on heads.
We should go.
I'm not sure I'm up to it.
How about we get you down there and then see how you feel?
I know what you're doing. Get in the shower, put your suit on, have something to eat, get in the car. Lets you know I'm giving evidence. What if I let you down? What if I fall apart?
You won't.
Can't you do it without me?
Without you, it does fall apart.
You've got another witness, just use her.
We can't. If you don't appear, then she won't either.
What?
Because what you've been through is worse. That's why she's willing to appear.
You know, if you can do it, then so can she. What about Vicky Miller? She can't speak at all, can she? Someone needs to do it for her.
Is the attempted rape victim here yet?
Her name's Paula, and the bad news is she might not appear. I'd say it's 50-50.
I'll start with the murder evidence for Vicky Miller. And until I know Ms. Merrick isn't appearing, I'm going to act like she is.
Right, the other bad news is Fallon Thomas has gone AWOL. We're looking for her, but there are no guarantees.
I can play for time with your forensics guy, but that could seriously undermine our case. Her evidence places Tom Norris at the murder scene.
Well, whatever happens, we've got Sophia Duya's strangling evidence.
Two attacks does not have the weight of three. I'll make the best of it I can.
Thank you.
Your arresting officer will be up first, then your forensics man, then lastly, the victims for maximum effect.
Unless it's victim, singular.
Whomever you can give me.
Can it get any worse? Was I
see. She's in court, she plays to win.
Tom Norris is on trial for attempted rape and murder. The evidence will prove how Norris's sexual encounters with different women became increasingly bizarre and violent. How what began as consenting sex ended with murder. When Paula Merrick ran from a violent sexual encounter with Norris, she became the victim of attempted rape. Vicky Miller was having a relationship with Norris. The night she ended that relationship, she became the victim of murder. We shall be showing how the strangulation and gagging of first his partners and then his victims will identify Tom Norris as the man who committed the murder of a young woman and the attempted rape of another. The Crown calls PC Nate Roberts.
I swear by Almighty God that the evidence I shall give shall be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth.
PC Roberts, will you please describe to the court the circumstances leading to the discovery of Vicky Miller's body?
Myself and PC Millie Brown were in pursuit of a stolen green Toyota Carina, index Lima 282, Golf Hotel X-ray. The vehicle stopped and the driver ran off. When we searched the vehicle, we found Vicky Miller's body in the boot.
Your Honour, I'd like to show the jury Exhibit P14, crime scene photographs of the victim. PC Roberts, was anything else of significance found in the vehicle?
Yes, a pay-as-you-go mobile phone.
Why was that important to this case?
On the phone, there was video footage of the victim arguing with the defendant, Tom Norris, on the night of her death. Norris was already known to us.
Why was Norris known to you?
He'd been interviewed a few days earlier at Sunhill Police Station about the attempted rape of Paula Merrick.
The attempted rape, which the defendant is also charged with here today?
That's correct.
Thank you, PC Roberts.
I have no questions for this officer.
Officer, you are free to leave the court.
Don't look up if it makes you feel nauseous.
I feel like I'm about to jump off a cliff.
I'll be with you the whole time.
I know this sounds silly, but will you hold my hand?
Of course I will. That's not silly.
All this DNA and fibre evidence, all this only confirms what Tom Norris admits. That he had sex with Vicky Miller in her car.
That's correct, yeah.
Not that he attacked Vicky Miller. Or killed Vicky Miller, or that he locked her body in the boot of the car where she was found.
Yeah. It's compatible with all of those things.
But it doesn't confirm any of them.
Forensics rarely does.
Which brings us to Exhibit 42B. According to Fallon Thomas, who stole the car we're discussing. The man who locked the vehicle boot also handled this can, and you're saying he left his fingerprints.
Exhibit 42B does have Mr. Norris's prints on it, yeah.
Well, I'm so glad you're here. How are you feeling now?
Terrified. I didn't want to let the other girl down.
Vicky?
Sophie. I told Paula that Sophia Dew wasn't giving evidence unless she did.
Well, that was a very brave decision you made, Paula.
The car was recovered elsewhere, so you don't actually know where it was parked at the alleged murder scene.
Well, I know where Fallon Thomas says it was.
How near was the can?
3.8 metres from the car, as it says in the diagram.
But again, these details don't confirm how it got there. You're not qualified to say the man who locked the boot is the man who handled the can, are you?
I think I am qualified. I wouldn't say it, no.
Why not?
Because I'm not the witness who saw him, am I?
You are a genius.
It's a little white lie, but I thought it was worth it.
Well, you got it here, and that's what counts. Well done. All the merit came through.
Thank God for that.
For the first time today, I feel like we're on track. How's Eddie doing?
The jury have asked to see the crime scene.
Why? Did he go off message?
No, the defense are hammering away at this canned stuff, but he's fine. Playing to the gallery as usual.
Okay. You go with them. Now that we're back on track, I want to stay there.
This is where the car was allegedly parked, facing that wall. And the man at the boot of the car here is described as throwing the can from here to there, with the witness who then stole the car watching from behind that wall there.
What was the exact position of the can?
Enjoying yourself?
Keeping an eye on you, waiting for the googly.
The jury asked to come. They've got every right to look. You should be pleased. You'll make them more receptive to your little joyride as evidence when she gets to court.
They can look at photos and diagrams. A lot cheaper on the taxpayer than dragging them down here.
I'm surprised you started with the murder. I'd have expected you to build up to it and run the attempted rape first.
Now, from here, the witness had a clear view of the parking area.
Look at him here. Well, passed by looking for Fallon Thomas. Thought we'd give you an update.
And? Still looking. Pretty much driving around in circles now. Been everywhere.
Find her. What if we can't?
Not an option.
Now, any further questions, Mr. Alessandro? We'll be happy to answer them. Could we meet over here, please?
No, routine.
Not trouble with your witnesses? Like cold feet or hangovers?
No, no witness trouble. Waiting at court, ready to go.
Good. So am I.
The other girl, Sophie's going to be here.
Yeah, after you. You kept apart.
Why?
Well, so you don't collude. You know, like making your stories the same.
What's he doing here?
He told me this is worth a wait.
Mr. Cox's prosecution witness. He was in the club the night Vicky Miller was killed, so his evidence relates to that.
He's staring at me.
Mr. Cox, can you come with me, please?
They told me to wait.
The quarterback from the visit, and you'll be next up.
You're a friend of the defendant, is that right?
Yeah, we share a flat.
So you don't really want to be here giving evidence against him?
Not really.
Initially, you claimed you saw the defendant inside the Andromeda nightclub just before 1 o'clock.
Yeah.
But you withdrew that statement.
Yeah, I got the times wrong. I couldn't be sure.
Can't say he definitely wasn't in the club at that time either. It was busy, crowded. He could easily have been inside.
Yeah, absolutely.
Were you home the night Paula Merrick came back with the defendant?
Yes.
Did you hear them in the bedroom?
Yes.
Was Paula Merrick screaming or calling out for help?
No.
When Vicky Miller came to the flat on previous occasions, was she screaming or calling out for help?
No.
Did you have sex with Paula Merrick or Vicky Miller?
Your Honour, the defence called this witness to ask about his evidence. I don't see the relevance of it.
Your Honour, a previous witness told the court the only common denominator between these incidents was the defendant. What about this man?
Your Honour, with respect, there is no evidence at all for a sexual connection between this man and either of the victims. He's a witness.
I'm making the point, Your Honour, that the connection between the defendant and the victims is as circumstantial as the one between the witness and the victims.
The point is inadmissible, Your Honour.
I agree. The jury will disregard what has been said.
I have no further questions, Your Honour.
Now, remember, you don't have to see Norris. Okay, there'll be a screen to one side of you so that he can't see you, but the judge and the jury can. Right.
Lawyer!
Oi. Please, get this man out of here!
He never done nothing to you, you didn't want... If that one hadn't cried rape, then Tom wouldn't be in the first place.
Yes, all right.
Get him out!
Lawyer!
I don't know how that happened. I'm so sorry, Paula.
Paula Merrick.
Okay. Deep breaths.
Do you need a minute? Because I can ask.
No. I want this over with.
Shut up and cool off.
She's to blame for all this. If she hadn't cried rape, you wouldn't even think of Tom for the murder.
You reckon? Your mate Norris had a violent sexual encounter with Vicky Miller before she was killed. I think we'd have got round to him without Paula Merrick.
It's not right, none of this. All they're interested in is catching you out and showing you up.
Defense counsel acts in the best interest of their clients. You don't like it, take it up with Norris. She's following his instructions.
He wouldn't do that, that stinks.
Welcome to the justice system. They throw mud at you and everyone. It's the only way to make Norris look less dirty.
DC Banks, I wanted to talk to him.
It's all right, I put him straight.
Well, actually, I decide what's all right. And that was assault and intimidation.
I don't think it was calculated. Garvey lashed out at the wrong person. I told him it was unacceptable. In the statement you gave to police, you told them you went to Tom Norris's flat with the intention of having sex with him.
Yes.
I know this is difficult for you, but in your own words, can you tell us what happened?
He got too rough with me, so I left. I grabbed my things and ran out.
What in particular did he do that you found too rough?
He strangled me. When I told him to stop, he put his hand over my mouth.
Would you mind showing the court how he put his hand over your mouth? He held your mouth shut, covering your nose.
Yes.
And when he released you, you say you ran from the flat. What happened then?
I was scared. I ran down Cold Farm Lane. I stopped just to check I hadn't left my mobile phone. Then it was attacked from behind.
I'd just like to direct the jury to exhibit piece 16. Photograph of Cold Farm Lane. How were you attacked?
I was grabbed over my mouth. My nose and mouth were covered.
In the same way?
Yes, in the same way. It was him again.
How do you know it was him?
I could smell him. He smelled exactly the same.
I'm sorry to make you relive all this, but can you tell us what happened next?
He pushed me against the wall, still with his hand over my mouth. I started to pull up my clothes with the other.
So he was suffocating you and trying to force himself on you at the same time?
Yes. I thought I was going to pass out. Instead, he pushed me away. I fell over. Then I did pass out. I realised afterwards someone coming along must have scared him off. So they saved me.
Saved you from what?
From being raped and killed. I really must object, Your Honour.
Your Honour, I've no further questions.
That must have been a very frightening and dangerous experience. Yes, it was. On the one hand, you just had a distressing sexual experience. Yes. On the other, you were violently attacked in the street?
Yes.
So we're talking about two separate events.
It was the same man.
But still, two separate events.
Hi. Is Samantha here?
Yeah, she's in court watching the other victim give evidence.
How's she doing?
Holding her head up. When she's done, she'll come out and then it's your turn.
Had you been drinking at all the night this happened?
What's that got to do with being attacked?
The barman at the club has given a statement saying you had at least 10 vodka and tonics.
It was less.
He's wrong?
Yes.
But you do like a drink. You do regularly drink a lot.
If you mean about going to AA, that was after the attack. I drank because of nightmares, but only after.
Really? Didn't you see a psychiatrist in November? That's before the attack date.
Your Honour, I do not believe that this is relevant.
It relates to credibility, Your Honour.
You may continue this line of questioning.
You just told the court you only had counselling after the attack, but you're under oath to tell the whole truth. You saw a counsellor prior to the attack because of your drinking, didn't you? Because you'd had blackouts and couldn't remember what you'd done.
No.
I have a statement from your ex-husband that says you did.
I didn't have blackouts.
Are you aware of the relevance of your evidence about the precise way the defendant held your mouth?
Yes.
The Crown has argued that the bruising you received on your face was identical to the bruising on Vicky Miller.
Yes, I know.
Might you have received the bruising on your face from the attack in the street?
Yes.
If it wasn't Norris who attacked you in the street, the details of your bruising are irrelevant. There would be no connection.
But it was Norris.
And if you're mistaken? It doesn't just affect the charge of attempted rape. It suggests my client is capable of murder. In the flat, you saw Norris. You'd gone home with him. You knew it was him. In the street, you didn't see anything.
He held my mouth the same. He covered my nose. I couldn't breathe.
In the street, you passed out. What about in Norris's flat? Did you pass out there?
No.
So in the first instance, you could breathe, and in the second, you couldn't. There must have been a difference in the way they held your mouth.
It was the same. They smelt the same.
They?
He.
There's a human being in the dock, Paula. This case has turned his life upside down. Can you really allow your identification to depend entirely on smell? Isn't it true they smelled the same because they both smelled like men? Because that's what they were. Two different men. I have no further questions, Your Honour.
She needs some privacy. Where can we take her?
Sophie Adu's in the witness room, so she can't go in there.
Move, Sophie. And you can go in there and get yourself together.
I'm going to the bathroom. I need a minute on my own.
Okay. Why didn't we know about the psychiatrist?
It wasn't in her notes. She must have gone private.
Playing to win is one thing, but that was something else.
Where do you think that leaves us?
Angry, actually, is where it leaves me. Because the truth of that woman's ordeal is being smothered. That was a hatchet job.
Gone? She's not down there.
Where's she gone?
The barrister's a total bitch.
What are you doing? We're not allowed to talk to each other.
Well, I just came up for a pee.
Did you discuss the details of your evidence?
Details? No.
You come with me.
Are we still on for lunch?
What's going on in there?
Don't jump to any conclusions. That was an accident.
As I understand it, Paula Merrick went to the laboratory to compose herself after the humiliation she experienced at the hands of the defence. Sophie Aduya was already in there. It wasn't planned or deliberate.
So why were two police officers there?
You're concerned about collusion.
I'm concerned about police orchestration of collusion, Your Honour.
There was no orchestration.
The entire prosecution case depends on these attacks being similar. The prosecution wants Sophia Duya's experience to mirror Paula Merrick's.
Her experience does mirror Paula Merrick's.
Coaching this witness to use the same words and the same descriptions will create mirroring where there is none.
What did Miss Merrick say to you?
She was upset. She said she'd been humiliated.
Did she say anything about breathing?
That I'd have an easier time of it if I said I couldn't breathe. If I said I passed out.
It's a mistrial.
Oh.
Jury's been discharged. This is disastrous.
I'm sorry.
What have you got to be sorry about?
That it happened. You've put a lot into this. But better to have a second crack at it than he gets off.
Well, your wife is asking for bail.
Norris won't get it.
I think he will. The judge is furious with us for supposedly orchestrating collusion between witnesses.
Tom Norris's bail conditions. I wanted to give you a copy personally. So there's no danger of any harassment or capricious arrest when he's released.
He has to stay at his parents and avoid contact with witnesses.
Yep, Joe, D.I. Nixon. I need you at court right now. It's to do surveillance. Get Mel to take Paula home. You can go back and tell the DCI what's happened.
What are you going to do?
I'll find you later. Might feel like you walked free, but you haven't.
Still beats the remand wing at Shadwell.
You'll be in Cat A next time. Second trials are very good for the prosecution.
Not when your witnesses are Alkies.
You stay away from the witnesses. You mess with any of them and you won't know what's hit you, Norris.
Yeah, and you stay away from me. I'm an innocent man. You've already stolen months of my life. Now get lost.
You got him?
Yeah, I've got him.
You take it from here. Where he goes, who he sees, I want to know where he is the whole time.
Will do, Gov.
How in God's name could that happen? I mean, it's a basic mistake. You're both experienced officers.
Paula Merrick got upset and we assumed the other girl was in the witness room.
Well, that's why you don't assume. Yeah. Banks is just filming in.
Norris has got bail. I want authorisation for a surveillance.
On what grounds?
He approached me outside the court and made comments that could be taken as intent to intimidate witnesses.
He said he was going after the witnesses?
Well, not in so many words, but he was aggressive and he believes that his accusers are responsible for him being banged up, which is a dangerous combination in a murderer. At least 24 hours, Gov. He's not a patient man, he's just got out.
All right, I'll clear it with the superintendent.
Thank you.
Can you hang on, Bagsy? Look, regardless of this bail fiasco, I want your opinion. Where do you think we stand? Are we going to win second time around?
I don't know, Gov. The connections look solid, but something doesn't feel right. If we can't make the connection between Paula and Vicky, then I don't think we can win.
So what are you saying? You can't prove the connections? Or there aren't any?
In light of today, I really don't know, Gov. But I don't want to talk out of turn until I've had a chance to go over again.
Okay, you do that. But if there's anything that you're worried about, you come and find me and we'll talk through it together.
Where is he?
Over there.
This is where he attacked Paula Merrick.
But that's completely nuts. Why would he come back here?
To revel in it. If he thought we were here, he'd probably enjoy taunting us. It's all grist for the mill.
For what?
For his next move. Whatever he's thinking up in that sick mind of his right now. Norris isn't supposed to be here. If he approaches Cox, he's in breach of his bail conditions.
Doesn't look like he wants to be seen. So Dan's leaving.
And Norris is going in.
What now?
We wait.
What do you think he's doing?
Collecting something? I don't know. Let's see what he comes out with.
Hold on, Dan's coming back. Gov.
Just give it a minute.
We can't just sit here.
Assistance to 2A Railton Avenue.
Enough!
Tom Norris, I'm arresting you for assault.
No!
You do not have to say
it. It was him, look at me!
Harm your defense. I saw you punch him.
He attacked
that
me!
That is intimidation of a witness.
You put him up to this, didn't you?
Get out.
Another stinking fit up. Can you smell that, Dan? That's the stink of a bent copper.
Oi, on your way. On your way!
I hit him out of self-defense. He hit me first.
Why were you there? You knew it was against the conditions of your bail.
I want you to go and get some stuff, clothes and that. I waited for him to leave.
Why didn't you get your father or somebody else to collect your things for you?
I wanted to get them myself.
Why is that?
I just did.
What was the fight about?
Listen, I went to get my stuff. He comes running in, I get hit, and suddenly I'm arrested. Which means you're watching me. You think I can't spot a fit-up when I see it?
I witnessed you assault Dan Cox.
You see what you want to see. It was self-defense.
Interview terminated, 1640.
So why were you outside my flat if it wasn't a fit-up?
Mr. Norris.
You'll regret you ever did this to me.
Is that a threat, Mr. Norris?
Wait and see.
Put him back in the cells, please, Joe. We saw you leave the flat and then go straight back. Why did you do that?
He called me and said he'd be at work if I wanted to talk.
So he deliberately got you out of the flat?
Yeah.
And why did you go back?
Something in his voice. Didn't trust him.
So how did the fight start?
I wanted to know what he was after.
And what was he after?
His clothes, he said. I didn't believe him. It's different now.
In what way?
I was loyal to him. Nothing I said was incriminating. Doing that in court, making me look bad, insinuating things, that's not right.
Who hit who first? Listen, if he hit you, you can still prosecute.
I hit him. What happened at court, he said it was tactics and I shouldn't take it personal. You don't do that to a friend.
So you hit him?
That's right, I hit him.
All you need to know to get the body you've always wanted.
So is there nothing in there incriminating? Nothing to suggest a reason for sneaking around? Mm. I don't get it.
Maybe he was looking for something specific.
My concern, Joe, my real worry is still that he's planning something.
Maybe Cox coming back stopped him getting what he needed.
Visiting the crime scene and then sneaking back to his flat is definitely planning something.
Well, don't worry, Gov, we'll be watching it.
We shouldn't have to. He should be locked up.
Thanks, sir.
It's all right, Millie. Let him have his moment.
That's right. Because I'm walking out again. You know why? Because you're wrong. You're wrong about what happened. Wrong about me. Wrong about everything you think.
I think you're the kind of man that has to have the last word.
I think you're an uptight bitch. See, I'm going home now, to my parents. I'm going to have a couple of beers, then I'm going to go out.
You're on a curfew.
That's right. But if I want, I might just go out for a drink, pull some girl, or before my official bedtime. And you can't stop me.
That's Fallon Thomas. It's her evidence to put Norris at the boot of the car.
So at this point, we're basing our case on the word of a joyrider.
Yes, Gov. She saw a man lock the boot of the car where Vicky's body was found. She saw the same man throw a can away, and we've recovered the can with Norris's prints on it.
And that's our continuity of evidence?
If Fallon Thomas can say it at the retrial, yes.
Trouble is, she runs away from anyone who goes to get her.
Are you happy with her evidence?
I could be happier. The jury think it's weak.
How do you know?
The barrister had to go over all this stuff again in situ.
Then I think we should go over it again, too. Take Eddie with you and bring Fallon Thomas in. If she's a liability or there's any more holes in this, I want to know about it.
Let's go, man.
Approaching Fallon Thomas's flat now, Gov.
Fallon? I don't believe it.
Fallon! Leon!
Leon, is that Fallon Thomas by any chance?
And Juno.
We're on our way.
Fallon!
What's all the fuss? Do you want something?
You had a court date.
Before I ain't done nothing.
As a witness.
Oh, yeah, I forgot about that. Come on.
Yeah, cheers, Mel.
Oh, it's all right, Leon. We'll take her. And the credit. See ya.
Nothing wrong with the view.
So what? You want me to chuck the can?
Yeah, Fallon said he took it off the back seat and shut the door. Do it that way. Now walk back to the club.
We found Fallon.
Great. Does Leon and Aaron know?
Yes. Don't ever send a man to do a woman's job.
Thank you. Wanna get out?
I've been through this before.
Then it shouldn't be a problem. Eddie, can you do it again, please? Is the van where the car was?
Yeah.
Stop! Now, you sure you got a good clean view of what you told us in your statement?
Yeah. He looked in the back seat, chucked the can and left.
You can see his face, Fallon. Look at him. If you were here, you can see his face. Run! Don't be stupid. Just tell the truth. Did you even see a man at the car?
You calling me a liar?
Yes, either you did and you saw his face or you didn't see anyone. Which is it?
You got the fingerprints on the can anyway. What does it matter? I already told you. I saw his back.
Not from there, you didn't. Anywhere you can see the car, you can see his face. Were you on the roof? This is where I'd be if I wanted to boost a car, and you can't see any faces from up here. Fallon, come here. What did you see from there to the back door of the club?
He went back in.
Did he look round?
No. Right before the door, he, like, wiped his hands.
Show me.
Like that.
Wipe them or remove something.
Gloves. That's it, he took them off.
Are you sure that's what he did?
Yeah. He took his gloves off. Right there.
Joe, stay where you are. If Norris comes back, contact Uniform and then me. In that order, please.
Gov?
Where have you been?
I think we've got a problem. I took Fallon Thomas back to the murder scene. She changed her story about a vantage point. To cut a long story short, the man she saw had gloves on. If he had gloves on, then the prints on the can are meaningless. No longer means it was Norris.
A girl's been attacked. You know where?
Where?
The same alleyway Paul and Merrick was found in. And where Tom Norris went earlier today. And now he's not at his parents' house. I want you to come with me.
Yes, ma'am, but unconscious and badly beaten.
Is it sexual?
Her underwear's missing. She was on the right where the DCI is. A young lad on a bike found her.
Thank you, Millie. Gov, Norris was here earlier after he was bailed.
I thought we were watching him.
Joe was watching the house, but he obviously sneaked out. And he's not there now.
Had the victim been strangled or have any bruising around her mouth?
Paramedics said so, yeah.
Same location, same method.
There's a lot of similarities, granted.
It has to be Norris. Everything we know about him so far leads us right back here to another woman being raped.
I hope you're wrong.
I should have stopped this. I failed.
Next time on The Bill.
Suspect's out of black. He's heading north up Hockley Road. Over.
He's calling a cab.
And he's packing a bag. Tell Will and Mel to take the lead. We'll be right behind them. Maybe you should think about your future here, because I will not work with someone I cannot trust.
Previously on The
Tom
Bill.
Norris, I'm arresting you for assault. He's definitely planning something. Same location, same method.
There's a lot of similarities, granted.
Not allowed to talk to each other. It's a mistrial. The judge is furious with us for supposedly orchestrating collusion between witnesses. Norris was under surveillance. I mean, how on earth did that happen?
According to the surveillance team, he went into his parents' house and never came out.
Well, he's not there now. And another one of his victims is lying in hospital.
I know it looks likely, but we can't say for sure it was Norris yet.
Well, you might not be able to, but I can. Norris should never have got bail. You know that, and so does that hotshot lawyer of a wife of yours.
Right, OK, listen up, everybody. Yesterday evening, Carol Peters was brutally attacked and raped in Coe Farm Lane. She's still unconscious. PC Ryder is in attendance at St Hughes, uniformer at the scene, gathering CCTV and talking to witnesses.
The attack took place in exactly the same location as the attempted rape of Paula Merrick 7 weeks ago. As you know, our prime suspect at that time was Tom Norris. He was also on trial for the murder of Vicky Miller, but yesterday was granted bail because the trial fell apart on a technicality. He's awaiting retrial and is currently missing.
Now, we can't be sure that Norris carried out this attack. However, the injuries that Carol sustained are similar to those of Paula Merrick and Vicky Miller.
What kind of injuries, Gough?
Well, we're talking about bruising to the face, neck, cuts to the head.
As well as doing a day job at the factory, Norris works as a stripper, which is how he met both these girls. He had consensual sex with Paula and Vicky prior to attacking them. Sex which included strangulation and smothering.
But if he's awaiting retrial, why strike again?
Because he's arrogant. And he gets a kick out of pushing the limits, which makes him very dangerous.
So we got a witness in a rape case. A man out walking his dog described a 20-something male, black trousers, grey hoodie with a baseball cap who he saw running out of the alley.
What time?
Around 9 o'clock.
Did you get a look at his face?
No, all he could say was I see one. He ran out of the alleyway and then 3 or 4 minutes later, a silver saloon went speeding from left to right up Effa Street and he figured it could be the same guy.
Tom Norris drives a silver saloon.
Okay, well, until Carol confirms otherwise, we've got to work on the basis that we're dealing with a serial rapist and murderer who's on the loose and could strike again at any time. So that means you've got to work fast. PC Taylor, I want you to gather every scrap of CCTV you can from around Norris' parents' house. PC Green, I want you to look at Norris's phone records. Draw up a list of every call he made and received from 1 o'clock yesterday.
I'm going to talk to Norris's parents. I don't believe they don't know when or how he left the house last night.
OK, Joe, can you go with Sam? Banksy, I want you to check out the factory and the flat that Norris shares with Danny Cox. See if he's spoken to anybody.
Do you believe me now?
Look, whatever misgivings I had about Norris...
I don't blame you, Banksy, because I knew. I knew he'd do it.
I blame myself.
Tom, haven't you lot harassed him enough?
I can assure you, sir, there's a very good reason why we need to speak to him.
I'm afraid I unearthed him. He's probably at home.
He's not. What are your shift patterns?
7 till 7. You check with his flatmate, Dan. He was working last night, so he's probably still sleeping.
Dan Cox. I'm headed there next. Thanks for your help.
You lot don't give up, do you? I've already told you I don't know where he is. He was in hours before his curfew. You've no excuse to keep tormenting him.
Last night, Mr. Norris, another girl was brutally attacked and raped in a similar manner to the crimes your son's been accused of.
Oh, God. Is she dead?
No, Mr. Norris, but she is yet to regain consciousness. So it's vital we establish your son's whereabouts, if only to eliminate him from our inquiries.
If you can, tell us anything. When you last saw him, where he might have gone, you need to tell us right now.
The truth. We're just as concerned as you are. Not because we believe he's guilty. We genuinely don't know when he went out or where he is. I know what it must look like. But I can put my hand on my heart and tell you my son is innocent. These accusations have ruined his life. My wife's terrified he'll do something stupid.
We're doing everything we can to find him, Mr. Norris. In the meantime, if you hear from him, you must contact us. For everyone's sake.
I will. As long as you lot promise to make this right. Catch the real criminal. And clear my son's name.
I can assure you, Mr. Norris, we want justice just as much as you do.
What is it, darling? I'm busy.
Around 9 o'clock last night, Tom Norris strangled and raped a young woman.
Did you catch him?
No. Do you have any idea where he is?
Are you serious?
You defended him, you got him bail. The only reason he's out is because of you.
No, the only reason he's out is because your DI tried to fix his trial.
That's not true, and you know it. He's raped another woman. He couldn't have done that inside, could he?
Don't take it out on me. I was doing my job. Based on the evidence presented, Norris would have walked free, mistrial or no mistrial.
At least Sam Nixon has the grace to feel bad about it. She blames herself.
And you blame me? Is that it? I feel terrible for any woman that gets raped.
And any rapist who wants bail as well. Walk away. Another girl is lying in hospital.
I'm Detective Inspector Sam Nixon. This is PC Mel Ryder. We'd like to ask you a few questions, if you feel up to it.
Did he rape me?
I'm afraid I don't know. The doctors would have to carry out an examination, and only if you're willing. Okay. In the meantime, do you feel up to telling me what you remember about last night?
I was walking home from a friend's house. It was just before 9. We'd had a few glasses of wine, so I decided to leave the car there and walk. I shouldn't have walked down the alleyway. There's a man jogging the other way and turned and got hit from behind.
Can you tell me anything about the man?
He had a cap on with a hood over it.
Did you see his face?
No. Just... I remember, like, my head exploding and then I couldn't breathe.
We think he was choking you.
Oh, God.
You stayed at your friend's most of the night? You didn't go out and have a drink or get talking to anyone?
No. We've been saving up to go travelling, so we haven't been out for ages.
Thank you, Carol. Been really brave. If you like, PC Ryder can stay with you while you have your examination. If you have any questions, she can answer them. And if you remember anything, anything at all, you must tell her.
enjoy?
No. I'm just going over Paula's case again to look for any more connections.
Not looking good for Norris, is it? So why does something tell me you're not so sure he's our man? Eddie says you two found something new at the Vicky Miller murder scene yesterday.
One of our key witnesses, Fallon, changed her story. She saw the killer at the boot of the car where Vicky's body was found, but says he was wearing gloves.
Meaning?
Meaning the killer didn't leave any prints. Now, that doesn't mean it wasn't Norris.
But it does cast doubt, doesn't it?
Hmm.
Not that there's any doubt in the DI's mind, of course, one way or another. Norris did it.
All the evidence is pointing to her being right.
It appears to be a random attack, which could be a sign of escalation. Now, Norris is a classic anger retaliatory rapist. Maybe he's no longer satisfied with punishing women he knows. He's now targeting strangers.
Right, so where are we at? No luck with the CCTV. No sign of a car.
Phone records?
Well, they show that Norris was in the area. So I've organised a printout of the data so we can track his movements.
I'm afraid I had no joy at the factory. Tried the flat that Norris shared with Dan Cox, but there was no answer. Apparently Dan was on night, so he's probably asleep.
Norris's phone records, sir. The last call made was to Dan Cox at 1958.
That's before the attack. Maybe Norris was checking Cox was at work. He'd need somewhere to go afterwards to clean himself up. I think it's time we gave Dan Cox a little wake-up call.
Excuse me, Mr. Cox. Second bed looks like it's been slept in.
So, was Tom Norris here last night?
I found Norris's bail conditions and a booking for his next strip show. He was here, Gov.
So, where is he now, Dan?
I've got nothing to say to you.
Dan Cox, I'm arresting you for assisting an offender. We know from his phone records Tom called you.
He wanted help. He's getting threatened. By text. Death threats.
Death threats?
From Vicky Miller's boyfriend. He thinks Tom killed her. Tom just wanted somewhere to stay. He didn't want his parents in danger.
Oh, and you let him?
I told him one night was it, then he had to go.
Andy Hicks went back to Australia. Vicky's boyfriend. He's not around to threaten anybody.
Tom showed me the text.
Last night, a woman was raped in the same spot as Paula Merrick. She's in hospital, traumatised and beaten.
It's got nothing to do with Tom.
I don't really have time for this. A man was seen running away from the scene wearing clothes that were previously described as Tom's. A grey hoodie and a baseball cap. Sound familiar? A silver saloon car was spotted. Tom didn't need your help because he was worried about death threats or concern for his parents. He wanted somewhere to hide from us.
What else did you do to help him?
I took him to Victoria Station.
When?
This morning after work. He said he was going to Dover.
To France?
You helped him abscond!
Well, he wasn't going to get a fair trial here, was he? Not were you trying to fit him up.
What about the girl, Dan?
Well, I didn't know about that, did I?
You convinced me.
We went to Victoria in his car. After I dropped him off, he asked me to dump it.
And did you?
It's in Darrow Road.
OK, everybody, listen up.
Cox dropped Norris at Victoria Station straight after his shift at 7 o'clock this morning. He's heading for Dover. DC Banks, I need you to circulate an all-port warning and check CCTV footage at Victoria Station. There's a chance we might catch him before he leaves the country. PC Taylor can assist.
Will, can you check Norris's bank accounts? They might tell us when he bought a ticket.
Cox claims he drove Norris's car to Victoria Station, which he later dumped in Darrow Road. This car could house vital forensic evidence, so DC Masters and I will head down there immediately.
I don't see it at the other end. Is he lying?
This is all double yellow, so I've just rung the council to see if it's been towed away. Dion Nixon. Yeah, Romeo Kilo 03 Lima Hotel Whiskey. That's great, thank you. Towed about an hour ago, still on the lorry.
You got the picture? He is circulated as wanted, if seen, detain. Thanks.
We're emailing all the CCTV images from Victoria Station from 7 a.m. onwards over now.
Dover are doing the same. There's an awful lot to trawl through, but we should be able to narrow it down to the time he bought his train ticket once his transaction records have come through. Unless he paid cash.
Jacob, there's no text from Australia on Norris's phone records. And Andy Hicks didn't have a clue what I was talking about, poor thing.
Thanks, Beth. I'll let Dion Nixon know. Are you ringing to apologise? What? OK, I'll be there in a minute.
I'm just nipping out for a minute.
No problem. Take your time.
What's wrong with the phone?
Nothing, except I shouldn't be doing this.
Doing what?
Reaching client confidence.
That's a turnaround.
Just listen. I think you should speak to Dan Cox.
Why?
Because his relationship with Tom Norris is creepy, to say the least.
Thanks for the tip, but we arrested Dan 2 hours ago.
What for?
Assisting an offender. Why? What's Norris said?
Pre-trial, he told me they go back further than Cox probably ever admitted to you.
Best news. Anything else?
Norris alluded to some trouble at a previous place of employment. Cox worked there too. He was concerned you might find out about it.
Any details?
Ask at the factory. Might be on their applications. It could even be something to do with their strip show. Anyway, I've already told you more than I should.
Signs of a conscience.
Don't push it.
I appreciate it. No problem, I'll try human resources. Thanks.
Did you find him?
No, not yet, but we will.
You won't find a single person in this factory who thinks Tom Norris is guilty.
I was here to ask questions about Dan Cox.
Dan Cox thinks the same as the rest of us.
Did Cox and Norris ever mention that they worked together somewhere else?
No.
Right, and even if they had, you wouldn't tell me because your mate Norris is such a good bloke.
He is.
Shortly before nine last night, a young woman was raped. Norris is AWOL. Unless it was he and you can vouch for him, I'm going to do my job. And your opinion about the man is not going to stop me. It's DC Banks, Sunhill. In case you or anyone else around here gets their memory back.
Anything significant, Addy?
Oh, I can tell you he's a pig.
I already know that.
There's chips under that seat that have been there for months. Speaking of which, it's lunchtime.
Come on, Eddie. What have you got?
Will this do you? It's blood.
Is it Norris's or Carol's? Can you bag it up for me, please? Yes, Gov. Okay, I'll be right there. Something's shown up on Norris's bank records. Okay, I'll have these photographed and then I'll get the uniform down to St. Hugh's to see if Carol can identify them and then straight to forensics. Let me know if anything else significant comes up here.
I love it when she's like this.
Hi. Are you okay? I've remembered something. It might be nothing. After the attack, when I was coming round, someone was moving me.
Do you think it was your attacker?
No, I don't think so. They sort of folded me on my side and they were holding my wrist like they were taking my pulse.
Okay. Was it a man or a woman?
I don't know. I'm sorry.
No, thanks, Carol. It might not seem like much, but even the smallest detail can be useful.
Carol, I'm PC Green. Sorry to interrupt, but D.I. Nixon has asked me to show you some photos of clothes we've recovered. We believe they may have been worn by your attacker.
Does any of this look familiar? Do you recognise anything?
Yeah, the hoodie, that's the same logo. Yeah, and that's the hat.
A purchase was made on Norris's debit card at Victoria this morning.
So on the face of it, Dan Cox told the truth.
Well, we've got enough to charge him with assisting an offender. But if he's cooperating, we should release him.
Well, I probably will, Gov, but not yet. Eddie's just found a hoodie with blood on the sleeve in Norris's car. I'd like to know whose blood that is. I'd also like to see what Banksy in uniform can turn up. Norris hasn't turned up yet?
No, and I've narrowed it down to the time when he bought the ticket. There's still a few more angles to go, though.
Why have you been left to do this on your own? This is priority. Where's DC Banks?
I don't know, Mum. He had a phone call. He had to nip out.
Nip out? What could be more important than this?
I need to speak to the manager about Tom Norris and Dan Cox.
It really is very urgent. Thanks. DC Banks.
Glenn?
Of course. No problem. I'm in the public corner of Taft Road. I'll wait outside.
Mum, these are the preliminary findings on Carol Peters. He used a condom.
Well, he'll be more forensically aware now. The other cases will have taught him that. Still strangulation and rape.
She remembers something strange. She thinks that she was put in the recovery position and had someone check her pulse after the attack.
What, Norris had a fit of remorse?
She thinks it was after he'd gone.
Thanks, Mum. Don't suppose you've seen DC Banks anywhere?
No, sorry, Mum.
This is a surprise.
Dan Cox wasn't there for the whole shift.
Okay.
He got a call about 8. He was doing maintenance on line 3, but I was close by. I got the impression he was on the phone to Tom Norris.
What was said?
Cox was saying, I don't know about any key, I don't know what you're talking about, but it was, like, heated.
Is that all?
No. 20 minutes later, I went to look for Dan. Couldn't find him anywhere. About 10 o'clock, he came up for his break, and when I asked where he was, he said he was working on line 6.
You didn't think he was?
No.
Why's that?
First off, we weren't even running line 6. We only run half as many lines at night. Secondly, I checked. It wasn't there.
So, from the time you heard them talking on the phone at 8 o'clock through to when you saw him upstairs at 10, he wasn't at the factory?
No.
You did the right thing. Thanks.
I take it you know what your client's done. I hope you're proud of yourself.
As I told my husband, Norris only got bail because of your transgressions in court.
Heaven forbid any victim should matter more than some trumped-up irregularities. A woman was raped.
Yeah. And the only reason I'm here is because Jacob told me you'd started to accept your responsibility in this chain of events.
Told you what?
Everything okay, Edgar?
Where have you been? I'll be waiting for you in my office.
Great. Just about to return the call.
Did you get anywhere with what I told you?
I will eventually, but the factory not in a hurry.
Tom Norris and Dan Cox both worked at a gym. Norris quit rather than face a sexual harassment tribunal.
How does Cox fit in?
He gave a statement saying he'd been there and the girl was lying.
You're a double act. Thank you.
DC Banks, in here now. Shut the door. What do you think you're doing telling Norris's barrister that we admit to fitting him up?
I never said that, Gov. I think you got the wrong end of the stick.
What was she doing here?
A bit of informal intelligence, Gov.
That better not be from you to her.
I think I'd do that outside the station.
Well, where would you do it, DC Banks?
That's not what I meant.
I think you and your wife ought to get your stories straight.
Are we done, Mum?
Not quite. Maybe you should think about your future here. Because I will not work with someone I cannot trust. Now we're done.
What was that?
Bang out of order, that's what.
What are you doing? Get out!
I don't care if you stick me on discipline charge for this. I'm going to say it. I do not care if you and my wife do not like each other, but I will not sit quietly for one and then the other to tell me I'm a bent policeman.
Ever since Norris's trial began, you have never believed that he is guilty.
I said the evidence was not a good fit.
So you go and find other evidence to undermine what we already have.
I was looking for holes because I knew damn well that the defense were ahead of us, so far ahead of us. You know what they think?
That Norris and Cox are in it together? Something Mel told me. Someone went back to the scene of the crime and put Carol in the recovery position. Doesn't fit Tom's MO. What's this?
Employment history. The two of them go back at least 4 years.
Sexual harassment? Where did you get this?
Naomi. So, officially, we don't have it. And what's more, one of Dan's colleagues developed a conscience. He told me that Dan left his shift after 8 and was missing until 10 o'clock.
Cox give us the con if he was involved?
To make us believe him.
To get out of custody.
But if we act like we don't know any of this and we release Cox, we can put him under surveillance. Intrusive surveillance in his flat.
So what do you think? You were sceptical last time.
I agree with the DI.
So will you authorise it?
Tom Norris is out there somewhere, Gov. He's extremely dangerous and all our leads have come to nothing. Cox could lead us to him.
Even if we charge Cox with what he's admitted, we'd have to bail him. By not charging him, he's going to think he's fooled us.
I understand the psychology. What worries me is the danger.
To put it another way, Gov, do we have a choice?
You're being released on bail, Mr. Cox, pending further inquiries.
You're not charging me with anything?
No. You could be charged with assisting offender, but in the light of your cooperation, we've chosen not to. However, given that you now know about last night's attack, if you assist Tom Norris in any way from this point on, you will face charges.
I understand.
If he contacts you and you fail to let us know, the same applies.
So in there.
Got visual on the suspect.
DR Nixon and Banksy are at the Arbo opposite Cox's flat. Keep them informed directly.
All received, over. Right, I'll stay one street back. Keep me posted, yeah?
So what we got here?
I'm trying to figure out where Cox might have met up with Norris so we can pull the CCTV and find the car.
Right, well, this might help. Some credit card info on Norris. Apparently he bought petrol on Tedder Lane at 8.50 last night.
On the way from the flat to the crime scene.
Check it out. Any CCTV on Norris, we want it.
Gov.
Okay, thanks, Will. Cox is a minute away.
If they are working together, what do you think the dynamic is? Do they take it in turns? One man on lookout, one man committing the offence?
Maybe Cox is always the backup?
It's possible. Doesn't fit the normal pattern.
Which is?
Everyone has a turn. That's what group rape is. Showing your mates you're a man, you're in control.
There's always a leader, the alpha male, and there's always a reluctant participant who tries to take care of the victim afterwards. Let's see if they get home safe.
Puts them in the recovery position. Cox is here.
He's calling a cab.
And he's packing a bag. Tell Will and Mel to take the lead. We'll be right behind them.
Will, have you got a visual on the taxi?
Yeah, we have visual.
Trader, D.I. Nixon and I will follow.
Roger that, Gov.
He's in the pub. Someone's leaving, Dern. He's a surprise act.
That accounts for the bag.
I was here earlier, looking for the manager. They're often a double act. But according to the booking form that Joe found at Dan's flat this morning, this was Norris's gig, not Dan's.
So Dan's covering for him. I want someone in there.
That rules me out, Gov.
Well, he'd recognise me. So that leaves Mel.
I'll go and give her the good news. Guess where you're going?
Dan Cox spent the whole day lying to us, correct?
With enough truth mixed in to make it stick, yeah.
Exactly. He's manipulative. But what's his end game?
To protect his friend.
Yes and no. At this stage, he's protecting himself. Okay. If we're wrong, and Cox is the innocent party, he can't lead us to Norris. If we're right, and Cox is implicated, then he has to know that sooner or later we're going to find something wrong. think I made a mistake. He's gonna run.
God, this gentleman is from the petrol station on Tedder Lane. Unfortunately, the CCTV isn't working there, so Omar here has agreed to come in and look at some photos for us. Okay?
No.
Him.
Are you sure?
Yes, positive. Him.
I think Cox may try and leg it, so I want you on foot round the back of the building, just in case. Dear Nixon.
We've got a positive ID on Dan Cox.
He used Tom Norris's credit card to buy petrol from a service station on Tedder Lane.
What time?
20:50 hours.
Thanks, Joe.
Cox was near the scene of the crime last night. We've got an ID. I want him back in custody.
What are we arresting for?
Assisting Norris, rape, everything.
Suspects at the back, he's heading north up Hockley Road, over.
Dear officer from 148, there's all available units for the vicinity of Hockley Road, over.
Proceed. Suspect has climbed the wall into Kitchener Park. He's heading towards Melkin Street.
Roger, heading that way.
Suspect's running north. We need to secure all exits, over.
Uniform backup on its way.
I have visual. Cox is heading towards the west
lane exit. Stop, Dan! I head him off! Head him off!
Sierra Roscoe from 531. Suspect now heading towards Sydney Road.
Proceed.
There's only one exit on Sydney Road.
Dan Cox isn't going anywhere. Dan Cox, I'm arresting you on suspicion of assisting in murder of Vicky Miller for the attempted rape of Paul.
Nice
Merrick.
Work, Will.
Thank you, Mo.
So what's your strategy?
Give Cox a get out. Buy into the idea that Norris is a sexual aggressor and he isn't.
Do you think you can flip him? Get him to tell us where Norris is?
That's what I'm gunning for. Why did you run, Dan?
Panic.
What have you got to panic about? Where were you at 8:50 last night?
At work.
One of your colleagues looked for you at the factory. He says you weren't there.
And we have positive ID of you buying petrol on Tedder Lane at 8:50. Okay. What this is, Dan, is a chance for you to account for yourself. You should take this chance. Okay? We know that he called you before you left work. What was that conversation about?
Keys.
What about keys?
I told him I didn't want him to stay. He said I didn't have any choice. He'd let himself in with his own.
And what did you do?
Drove home to have it out of him. He gave me this story about being threatened by Vicky's boyfriend. I made him promise to leave in the morning, and then went back to work.
You had the call at 8:00. 50 minutes later, you're buying petrol.
I did that on my way back.
Using Tom's credit card. Was Tom with you at 8:50?
No.
Then why were you using his card?
Okay, so he was with me.
What were you doing?
He asked me to drive him.
Where to? Cold Farm Lane.
He lied to me. He told me he's picking up a girl, like a bait.
Go on.
He told me to drop him off around the corner and wait. When he came back, there was blood on his sleeve.
And what did you do? The girl who was attacked told us that somebody tried to help her. Was that you, Dan?
With the benefit of the tape, the suspect nodded his head.
Why did you do that?
I didn't want her to die.
Like Vicky. He's out of control, Dan. Where is he?
Last time I saw him was at Victoria Station, I swear.
He's lying. If Norris went to Victoria, why isn't he caught on CCTV?
Cox is turning it off and on like a tap. On the upside, he's put himself at the crime scene.
And every time we interview that man, he gives us exactly as much as we have evidence for. Just...
go on.
What if I've got it wrong about Norris? What if they're not a double act and Dan has been acting on his own all along?
If that's the case, where is Tom?
I think we should be looking at Dan as our prime suspect. Take Joe and Eddie and go back to the flat and search it again, this time for things that link him, not Norris, to the crimes.
OK. He's admitted to being there, but not knowing what was going down until afterwards. There are holes all over it.
You know why Cox admitted going back to the girl, don't you?
Why?
Compromises the forensics. He uses a condom and anything else we find, he says it was because he was playing Good Samaritan.
What kind of car does Cox drive?
Mitsubishi.
Just found this at the back of the cutlery box. That's a strange place to keep your car key. And why did you take a cab earlier on?
Whiskey uniform 53, Hotel Victor Zebra. Black Evo? Let's have a little look.
Hey, hey, Joe. Found this in the bin. It's a car park receipt.
Look at the time on that.
7:25, sir.
So why would Cox go straight from work to leave his car in a car park less than half a mile from where he lives, to then hide the keys and throw away the ticket?
Let's find out. There it is.
He's Banksy. Banksy!
Oh my God, it's Tom Norris. Is he dead?
Sierra Oscar from DC Masters. Urgent assistance required. Gateley car park. Gough, Norris is alive, but only just. He's been severely beaten. They're trying to stabilise him at St Hughes.
Cox left him for dead. Uniform are chasing up CCTV at the car park, which is bound to place him at the scene.
We need to know about the others. Norris is in the car, absolutely. But what about these women? What could possibly have been his motive?
Carol Peters was a cynical attack to frame Norris. He wore his clothes, he drove his car.
Possibly. But did he kill Vicky?
And did he rape Paula Merrick? If so, why? Who was his real target? The women? Or Tom? Did he do everything we thought was Norris, purely to frame him? And will he blame everything on Tom?
Yes, he will. Because he thinks Tom's dead. And dead men can't talk.
Hello, lovely people. Look what I found in the boot. Looks like it fell out of Norris's trouser pocket.
It's a car key.
Yeah, bingo. This is the key in the Vicky Miller murder case. Whoever hid her body in the boot of the car had to have had this key.
It was an accident. We had a fight.
When?
When I went home during my shift, like I told you before.
So what happened?
We had an argument that turned into a fight. I pushed him down the stairs. I think he might have broken his neck. He wasn't moving.
Why don't you call the police, an ambulance?
I just didn't.
Can you tell me what that is?
A key.
This key is the reason you didn't dial 999, isn't it?
I don't know what you mean.
I think you do, Dan. This is the key to Vicky Miller's car. The car her body was found in. When Tom Norris called you at 8 o'clock, he just found this key in your flat, hadn't he?
No.
I don't know about any key. I don't know what you're talking about. We have it on good authority that these are your exact words.
I already explained that. It's about Tom breaking his bail conditions, letting himself into the flat.
No, Dan. Tom worked it out. Why you had Vicky's key and how you sat back and let him be accused of an attempted rape and murder you'd committed. That's why you had a fight.
No. It was about him letting himself in. I've already told you.
The journey from the factory to your home takes about 15 minutes. If Tom Norris was lying at the bottom of your stairs before 8:30, how can he commit a rape at 9 o'clock?
He can't. But you can.
You took his car, his clothes, his wallet, and you raped a complete stranger. You went to elaborate lengths to make it look like it was him.
You thought Norris was dead. You've admitted you pushed him. But he isn't dead. You didn't finish the job. Your friend is lying in St. Hugh's, and I wouldn't be surprised if he's more than happy to talk to us. Look at me, Dan. Dan, look at me. It wasn't just Vicky and Carol, was it? We know you attacked Paula, too.
She was a tease. They all are. She was loving it, and then she thought she could just change her mind.
Why should you care? She wasn't your girlfriend, she was Tom's.
She wasn't his girlfriend.
Is that what always happens, Dan? Norris gets the girls and doesn't let you have your fair share.
No, he just picks the wrong ones. I told him she'd cry rape. She needs to be taught a lesson.
Oh, so you're protecting Tom. Okay. So what lesson did you teach Vicky Miller on Tom's behalf?
I didn't mean to kill her. But you don't understand. She liked what he did to her.
Help me understand.
Tom was sick of her. She was like a limpet. The worse he treated her, the more she wanted it.
And that bothered you?
What kind of woman enjoys that? It's disgusting.
You mean what kind of woman enjoys sex?
You should see them at our strip shows. They're all over us. And when it's finished, they put on this innocent act, like we're beneath them. Tom should never have gone anywhere near a girl like Vicky.
Did Tom tell you he had sex with Vicky in the car?
I didn't have to be told.
You watched?
No.
But you did go out there?
I went out there to tell her what he says about her when she's gone. What he really thinks about her.
And was she still in the car?
Yeah.
Did you get in the car?
Yeah. But not for what she thought. She thought I wanted her too. I wouldn't touch her with a 10-foot pole.
Did you strangle her?
She wouldn't shut up.
Did you strangle her?
I had things to say.
Did you strangle her?
To shut her up, yeah. But I didn't do anything else. I'd never go anywhere near a woman like that.
So Tom had nothing to do with it?
Yeah, then he just admitted it all. According to him, Vicky's murder was unintentional. And as for the others, he just wanted to teach them a lesson on Norris's behalf. He didn't think those kind of women were good enough for him.
I can see the diminished responsibility plea a mile off.
4 out of 4 serious crimes have been cleared up. There won't be any problem when this comes to court. So come on, you've both done a great job. I think it's time to call it a night, don't you? You coming?
I'll do one last thing to do, Gov, and then I will. How long have you been there?
Not long.
We've caught the man who attacked you. He confessed.
Did he say, why me?
Yes.
Why?
To copy a crime that happened in the same place.
I don't understand.
To make another man look guilty.
So I was raped to make someone else look guilty. That's crazy.
Yes, it is. When you're ready, we can tell you more. I just thought you should know we've got him.
How was she?
Vulnerable. You didn't have to wait for me. I could get a taxi.
I wanted to apologize.
No need. I should apologize to you. I made a mistake about Norris and you put me straight.
Teamwork. That's what it's all about.
I spoke out of turn about your wife.
There, I should have been more discreet. What I said to her...
I don't need to know, Banksy.
No, Gav, I want to say. I respect your commitment. And what I said to her was that you cared enough to feel it.
We all care. It's being effective that counts.
No, not everyone does, Gav. And what you just said, putting the two together, that's what I respect.
Thank you. It's mutual.
Can I give you a lift?
No, you go home to your wife. I'll get a taxi.
Time on the bill.
Where'd you get these, Charlie?
Got a watermark. Nearly perfect.
She could lead us straight to this counterfeiting operation.
Hang on a minute. I've got two kids at high risk here. I don't want you to frighten the living daylights out of them.
Get on the floor now!
Charlie, please!
I can't!